This is the Cool Photo Tools Podcast, episode number 61, April 4th, 2016.
Are you sick of trying to learn all the new photo software? Are you tired of hearing about the next big thing in photography? Well, neither are we. Welcome to Cool Photo Tools with Jay Bierstorff and Rhonda Spencer.
Today's sponsor is Audible.com, who has more than 180,000 audiobooks and spoken word audio products. Get a free audiobook of your choice at www.audibletrial.com/coolphototools. Good morning, cool heads, and welcome to a beautiful April episode of Cool Photo Tools. Behind me and off to my left is Rhonda Spencer.
Hello.
Photographer extraordinaire. Out in the air.
We're not going to go that far. Yeah, we're here.
But who cares?
Well, now we're getting closer. Okay. Now we're getting closer.
Well, it's April. Who would have thought?
Yay.
You know? So do you have any bad April Fool's jokes played on you this year?
No, people know better. Revenge is a terrible thing, you know.
That's true. Yeah. No, I don't like April Fool's jokes. And I always get mad when I fall for them on the internet. You know, somebody, if they make an April Fool's prank, you know, that you're like, you know, oh, wow, that's really, really? Let me check that out. And you look at it, you're like,
oh, yeah, you're kidding. Yeah.
Gotcha. You know,
yeah, that's true.
I'm blocking your website. I'm not going back there. And I'll never mention you again on Cool Photo Tools. You know, you will be punished.
Ooh, oh, wow. That's like, it's like so mean.
I know. Well, that's...
I know.
The crime fits the punishment or something.
That's one way of showing them.
Don't try to fool me. It may be easy, but I won't like it.
And you'll pay for it. You'll never get on Cool Photo Tools again.
Like, so did you see this?
What?
Jumping off of that really
okay,
fast.
Jump
okay,
off
that
of
was
that.
Going nowhere.
I know, so, it was yeah. Nowhere fast. What?
Yeah. All right. So this is what I'm talking about here. This is Schillers.com. And they have audiovisual prints and stuff and rentals. And they had this article I thought was pretty cool. And this is must-have apps for photographers. Hmm. And like, well, that would be me. And an app would be, you know, a program to run on your phone.
Mm-hmm.
And so they whole have a whole list of these pretty cool apps. So, you know, if you haven't seen these, this is a good list. You should take a look at some of these. I use a few. Do you use any apps on your...
I don't. I, you know, I'm one of those people, I hate to say, I really don't do a lot of imagery on my telephone.
Yeah, this is for you because your phone is just like a little computer.
Yeah.
You know, and you can, all those, sometimes you can, you know, you can calculate depth of field and you get charts on that kind of stuff and know when the sun rises and sets or know where the sun's going to be in the sky. There's all kinds of really cool apps that you can use to help your photography on your smartphone.
Ooh.
So, why wouldn't you?
Why wouldn't you?
I don't know. You got something on your computer? I don't see anything on your screen there.
Oh, that's because I've got something good for you guys. This is free. I love free. Oh, free is wonderful.
We like free.
OnOne Effects is giving OnOne Effects free 10. You can download. It is the program. They're giving it to you for free.
Okay, so this is OnOne.
OnOne.
That used to
and
be
it's
called.
Effects.
Used to have another name before they changed it to OnOne. What were they
no,
called?
No, it's been OnOne Effects for some time. Mm-hmm. So this is OnOne Effects, and it's a photo editor, and it's free, and they give you like little here's some little different stuff on teaching you how to use it if you want to use it for different things. They've got all sorts of like little videos. But the best part, like I said, this is legitimately free. So you have all sorts of different presets. Let's see if we can bring up some of the presets. I haven't played with this a lot. That allows you to do all sorts of different things with your imagery. I mean, this is, how much better can you do for free?
Honestly? I don't know. I haven't tried. Well, there are some online things, you mm-hmm. know, that you could do that are pretty cool, but...
And this is the full program.
Okay, and now let's now remember that the OnOne has a whole bunch of programs in their suite. They have an OnOne suite.
Uh-huh.
And so this is just one of those programs that is in the suite, because they want you to get excited about it. They're giving this away so you can taste the goodness, and then you'll want to buy the rest of their package, which has the other programs in it, which they got some pretty cool ones.
Yeah. Well, like I said, lots of different, you can see here, if nothing else, to just download it and play with it for free.
Yeah, and you should, because if you're not doing any digital editing right now, you're missing out on half the fun of photography. Mm-hmm. Digital photography, it's really requires, I think, be involved so that you can make those pictures look like like you saw them in your mind. Cameras are not perfect, no matter how much you pay for them. You know, you're just getting what the camera manufacturer thinks is the best representation of a scene, and it may not be what your eye sees at all. So
anyway, I'm jazzed with this. Like I said, for free, who can ask for better?
Yeah, and you know, and one of the interesting things that OnOne is doing,
and it's got, like I said, it's got a lot, not just the presets, but like you can set and play with the presets and change it to how you want to see things.
So they kind of give you some visual examples of to get you started, though. That image that you're using, I don't know, is the best one.
I know, I'm sorry. It was just happened to be one that was setting.
At least on the TV screen, everything looks exactly the same. It's like, well, those don't look any different.
No, let me see.
So they're showing some different. While Rhonda's trying to find another image.
Yes.
The OnOne has been doing something. I see some of the other companies doing this, and this near and dear to Rhonda's heart, because she really has been unhappy with Adobe since they went to a subscription model.
They made me mad.
Yeah, it's kind of like April Fool's, you know, but it wasn't a joke. And while it's kind of a double-edged sword, you can see it where before there was such a high entry point to get into the full version of Photoshop, and now you can do it for $10 a month. You know, you can have that big program that was normally, that was $600 to get into it to start with. But I think there's still people that like, well, you know, I just don't need anything else I have to pay monthly for.
Yeah.
You know, I don't care what it is. I need to just own it and be done with it in order to keep my finances the way they are, or to, just for the way that they live. So I see a lot of companies. OnOne originally started as a Photoshop plugin. You know, so that was all their programs, you know, you would plug them in to Photoshop, and then you would use them from within Photoshop. But now, because there's this kind of this backlash, small that it may be, against people wanting to subscribe to everything, they have made all their programs freestanding. So now you can use all the OnOne stuff without Photoshop anywhere near it. And so that sets them kind of another thinking. They're like, well, if we could do that, then why maybe we should just even do Photoshop-like features. We could replace Photoshop in a lot of instances. So we would actually be in competition with them, rather than relying on them to provide a platform for our plugins. So you see other companies doing this as well that used to be effects are now standalone. You could still use them as plugins with Photoshop, but they will stand alone, and you don't need Photoshop or any other program to support them. All right, Rhonda, how are you coming over there with that?
Hold on. So, all right, let's look at some of the different things that you can do here. Black. Let's do it to full screen.
So okay, so now I can see some differences in those images.
Okay, good.
Yeah, go full screen on us. So Rhonda's looking at the OnOne effects. This is their free version.
This is their free version.
And this is one, and you can see that it kind of gives you little tiny thumbnails, so you can kind of preview.
You can preview.
Ooh, that's I like that one.
You like that one?
Yeah, I like that one a lot. I'm going to have to download that. That's free?
Yeah, totally free.
So actually, I think I have the paid version somewhere.
We'll give you the link. Yeah, well, I have the 9 version, too, that's a paid version. Yeah. But this
I need to upgrade to version 10.
This is 10.
Yeah, I know. That's I'm saying. I just need, I have the whole suite, but I need to upgrade to 10.
You know,
but that's pretty nice. I just, you know, in one click, you can go shopping for effects by just browsing through those thumbnails.
Yeah.
Click on them and like.
And say, all right, so you've got this, so you want to do something else with it. They give you the sliders. You can change things around here. Put your own little personal effects.
Yeah, you don't have to take the presets. You can adjust. Each preset can be adjusted to your own.
To whatever you choose to do.
But the presets give you a starting point. That's the powerful thing about the presets. You know, is that sometimes they'll give you an idea that you didn't even think of before. You're like, wow, look at that. That could be a really interesting way to treat that image, and I didn't even think about that.
Mm-hmm.
So it kind of is gives you a little kind of a creative tap on the shoulder sometimes.
Let's go with black and
help
white.
Help you do that. Yeah, black and white is designed for people that
don't see color.
Couldn't afford color. Now, wait a minute now.
Sorry.
Even colorblind people usually can see some colors. Monochromism is really rare. So that isn't, you know, in today's modern day and age, you know, black and white, they did that first because they know how to do color. But now, don't we only do black and white? It's just another special effect.
It is just another special effect.
It's just like an Instagram filter. I think too much weight is put on black and white. You know, it's like, that's just an effect. Yeah, nothing looks like that. You know, it's just an effect.
So anyway, they've got, like I said, a lot of different filters that you can do. I just think it's a great program for free. What more can I say? Great program for free.
Well, yeah, but now you own the rest of the suite. So obviously, it's besides just this being a great program for free, it's a pretty cool program,
mm-hmm.
and may tempt you into purchasing the rest of the suite.
Good.
Okay.
Good.
Well, we're going to put a link to that in the show notes as we do all of our stuff that's on.
I'm always trying to find you guys stuff for free. Just telling you, if I can find it for free.
Okay. Doesn't matter if it's any good or not. But if it's free, Rhonda's got it for you.
There he goes again.
I don't think everything has to be free. You know, we need to pay for developers to continue to make software and hardware for us. I don't have a problem with paying them. You know, if it's something that I use. And
but I like free also.
Well, yes, I know you do. Rhonda's our free champion.
That's right.
Here at Cool Photo Tools.
That's right. Is GIMP still free, by the way?
Yes.
See?
Yeah, so that's another photo editor that is free, but it's a little quirky. But there are people that use it, you know, for all important stuff. It certainly has capable features. It's not going to get the latest and greatest features on that, but sometimes you don't need them. Sometimes you just need basic stuff.
True.
All right. And when I say all right, that means I'm changing subjects.
Yeah, I figured that much.
Okay. So here's a website. And this one is actually talking about a product. This is from ePhotoZine on the internet. And ePhotoZine has this article about Gigapixel photo technology. And Gigapixel is a device that you attach to your camera, and then it pans around. It helps you take pictures that then will be later stitched together on your computer so that you have one huge image. And it might be a panorama, usually a panorama, sometimes even a photosphere. And it's in such high resolution because it might combine 20, 30, 40, or 50 pictures together, you know, single images, single 24 megapixel images, stitches them all together into one seamless giant image. So these are kind of fun to look at on the internet, and that's probably, again, where you would probably look at them because they're so huge, you couldn't, you know, you'd have to make a print the size of Yankee Stadium to get to look at it. But this particular website is showing some of this Gigapixel technology that is used here on St. Paul's Cathedral. And you can spin around and you can see they have exteriors. And it's kind of cool. So link to that in the show notes if you're interested in these giant images. And the devices that make these, you can get these from bnhphoto.com. Gigapan is one of them. There's a couple of companies that make these. And you attach them to your camera and push the button and stand back. You put them on a tripod and it motorizes, it moves the camera in position. And some of them even will push the button. We'll take the picture for you. You don't even have to do that. Hmm. Then it moves to the next position. You push the button and it moves to the next position. You know, it could take 10 minutes or so or longer, depending on how many that you have stitched together. So we'll put links to those in the show notes for you. All right, Rhonda.
All right, Jake. So
what you got?
This is another free. This is actually called Open to Study. It's
sounds like work.
Well, it could be, but you know, sometimes we work in order to make ourselves better. So they have lots of different featured courses.
This is all free?
This is free, yeah.
All of it? The whole thing is free?
Yeah.
Well, what's up with that? How's anybody going to make any money?
I don't know. They do it for education purposes.
Wow.
I know. Is that not? And so these are actual online free courses.
Of course, you know, you get what you pay for. Have you looked at any of these?
I have.
And?
And here you go. So this course actually runs a certain amount of time.
See, now there's...
Yes.
Okay. All right. So, yeah. So anybody could make one of these and put them on there? And,
well, I think you actually send in your images to it. It's more than just, you know, just study. You actually do the courses. You do the tests. You send in imagery. Rhonda had it where you could hear. Can you hear when I put this on?
No, I purposely turned off the sound.
You did? Okay, yeah, well...
So we don't accidentally violate any copyright laws by playing music that we're not licensed to play. Or,
so anyway.
And then, you know, and we want to send them to the website. They don't get to just watch Cool Photo Tool and get it. You know, we'll link to it. You know, you guys, you go there yourself. Come on.
As you see, videos, quizzes, assignments. So this is actually more than just, you know, this is really an online course. And they do several different types. They move them around all the time. They don't always just have this course. They have different courses that are up.
So what's the website?
This.
Open2Study.com.
Open2Study.
And the two, it's the letter two. So O-P-E-N.
Number two.
The number two, thank you. The number two, as opposed to the word two, T-W-O. Uh-huh. It's not that. So O-P-E-N.
Two. Study.
Numeral two. And then study, S-T-U-D-Y, and .com.
You have other things that you can look at other than just necessarily studying photography. There's lots of other courses. But it's a actual online free. I think it's actually from Australia.
Yeah, I see the URL, you know? It says Australia uh-huh. on it.
And they just have it open.
So they all talk with an accent?
They do.
Good to know.
But... Okay. You know, education for free. That's great.
Yeah. I like, free's good.
Free's good. I said I'm keeping free it with good. Free.
We, you know, we're good with free here.
All right, good.
So when you take pictures of people,
yeah.
Do you, and if you're going to, well, just if you take pictures of people, if, assuming, you know, you've got a number of levels to that, you could just take portraits, you know, mm-hmm. or you can take wedding photos. Mm-hmm. But if you take pictures that you suspect may at some point be used for commercial photography, mm-hmm. so that you're going to sell them to another company and they can use them as advertising, or you're going to sell them, or you're going to put them online with a stock photo,
okay.
Like iStock.com or Fotolia.com, or one of these, if you have people, recognizable people mm-hmm. in your images, mm-hmm. then you got to have a model release.
Yes.
And those of you maybe new to the industry or the careers or this kind of thing, it's really a no-brainer. You must have a model release. What a model release does is it sets up a legal contract between you and your subject that says the photographer, which is you, has permission to sell, spindle, mutilate, destroy, do whatever they want to the images that the photographer has taken. And for value received, or the money that you have paid to the model or the subject or the person, that's all they're going to get. Mm-hmm. And that's a typical model release. There's probably some variations around, but that pretty much means that I'm okay with photographer making me famous, mm-hmm. you know, at any level. And I think sometimes that can be a little confusing because, I think unless you know something about the law, and I'm certainly not a lawyer, that there needs to be this contract. If you do not get a model release and you sell that image and somebody puts it on a billboard, or let's
say
some advertising thing that you know that comes up, and there's no model release, then you open yourself up for the liability of being sued mm-hmm. For damages or for monetary purposes, particularly if maybe you sold or licensed an image to somebody and that every time they reproduce this image on a sweatshirt or a coffee cup that you get a percentage. Maybe you get a dime, maybe you get a dollar, something. So, and if it's really successful and you've gotten several million dollars from that, all of a sudden your model can come in and go, well, you know, you probably owe me some of that money. You don't even have a model release and could litigate against you. So it's really important just to do it up front, just as a matter of, if you think there's any possible way that you might actually ever sell that image to somebody, you have to have a model release signed. And you can download model release forms from the internet. And, you know, they don't have to be really complicated. They don't even have to be technical, you know, just an understanding.
Right.
Pretty much, you know, like this, for whatever reason, I'm going to give you 10 pictures for your portfolio, and that's all you're ever going to get from these photos from me. And in return, you give me permission to use this photograph in any way that I see fit, or to make any amount of money that I'm able to make, you know, or however it's worded out. I don't know that that would be, you know, perfectly the way I just said that. But anyway, it's worth finding out. And there's a really good article on this on Fotolia.com, which this right here, The Importance of Model Releases. And this is on Fotolia.com's blog, and I'll link to this in the show notes. And this essentially kind of walks you through that, as far as tells you the to do this, why it's important, and how to get this all handled. Fotolia is owned by Adobe.com now, and Fotolia is a very big stock agency. They have lots of good photographs available for stock. If you want to do use them in your magazine or your publication, you could.
Most of the time, with most publications, they are going to ask you if you had a photo release.
Yeah, because they could be liable as well. Yeah. And if you don't, then you're making them liable, you know, along with you. And so they're not even, nobody wants to do that.
Right.
You know, I think lawyers are you know.
Now you can get away with it if you've got like a back of a headshot or something where someone cannot be recognizable. But yes. As soon as a face becomes recognizable, you need a photo release.
And again, just as a disclaimer, let me say that neither Rhonda and I are lawyers, and so anything that we are saying here is strictly opinion and may not be construed as legal advice. We do recommend that you know, check the experts on this. But just, you know, to give you a heads up, you do need a model release, mm-hmm. you know, if you're going to sell your images.
And now, even if you're not going to sell, like a lot of the images that we use for the Arizona Sonora Desert Museum that are used as advertisement for the museum, we still have to get releases from people to be able to publish their work.
Unless they're an employee or unless they have, you know, signed a model release at some point. Which all their employees have, and sometimes students, depending on where they're at. Mm-hmm. You might be featured in an advertisement. I know that the commercial stuff I've shot for the museum, we always had model releases signed. Yeah, it's a no-brainer. It's just mm-hmm. something that everybody knows, but as a beginning photographer, you know, maybe this is the first time you're hearing this, so just wanted to throw it out there to you. Now, there's another thing that sometimes comes up, and this is news photos. And this is a situation, as I understand it, and again, I'm not trying to give out legal advice here, but if there is a newsworthy situation, mm-hmm. there's a traffic accident, there's a fire, something happening in public, not in private, this is happening in public. And so you as a photographer maybe are there as a news, maybe you're representing a newspaper, maybe you're a freelancer. And so will maybe take images of people that are recognizable. But because it's a newsworthy event and because it is in public, then people generally do not have an expectation of privacy in those situations. And those photos could be sold to a newspaper or to some other publication, such as celebrities. You know, if you take a picture of a celebrity that is out in public, well, they don't have a right to privacy. Yeah. You know, not in public. They do not. So again, you can take pictures of them and you can sell those photos to news agencies. Photographer Ron Galella, you know, his entire career based strictly on doing that, on taking photos of celebrities in public locations. Which is, there's a movie out on Ron Galella that's pretty interesting for photographers to see. And I'll link to that in the show notes as well. So, Rhonda, I see you've got something over here. You're chomping at the bit.
I'm not chomping at the bit. I just think it's very interesting. This is a 3D camera, and it's called a Matterport, and it would be great for real estate photography.
Now, I'm not seeing the 3D on. That's because I got the wrong thing selected. Oh, there
could
it is.
Could be. There you go.
I had the wrong camera selected. You got to check on me once in a while. I'm not falling asleep at the switcher here. All right, so now we're seeing the Matterport 3D for the real world website. Mm-hmm. And this is at matterport.com. And Oh yeah, this is kind of wild,
isn't it?
So how do you get How do you get pictures like this? Are these assembled? Are they you as a photographer shoot and then they put them together for you? Is that how that works?
Exactly. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, they have. So there's
this is fee based, and this would be something primarily for real estate agents that somebody's got a house that they really want to go the extra yard to.
So
you kind of do a walkthrough on it, and
the camera itself, I think, is like $4,500.
You can't just use your box,
No,
Brownie.
This is their Pro 3D camera right there at B. And so what did I say that it was? Hold on. Let's find where it is. Un momento, por favor, because I know it's like $4,500. It's not a cheap date right here. Yeah, $4,500.
Well, that's a lot of money.
That is a lot of money. But as you see, it looks like it does what it's supposed to do. I mean, I was just really impressed.
So this would be something that really a real estate professionals. I'm trying to think who else would be interested in this. I don't know. I suppose there are other fields or businesses that would be interested in coming up with. And I see looking at your screen over there that they also have some virtual reality
glasses.
So the upcoming virtual reality revolution is going to be all set for this. You'll be able to put on Google Cardboard or some of these other VR glasses and get a virtual reality tour of some of these homes. You could just kind of wander around in the home and see, try it on for size, see if it fits.
Not only for that, but at any business that you had that you wanted to necessarily show off your business, hotels, motels, think about it. Any type of virtual reality tour.
Yeah, and I don't know, are you buying into this, you know, that there have been saying, oh, virtual reality is all up and coming, and this is, or augmented reality, AR, VR, is going to be the next big thing. Are you thinking that might be?
I don't know. It looks like it would be a fun thing to do. Here's one, just showing them kind of just going through.
So this isn't actually 3D other than, it's just a virtual walkthrough. That 3D is just kind of that things change as you walk around here. There's not a 3D effect per se.
That's pretty cool,
maybe,
though.
You know, maybe there could be. Now, I don't know. If you're using the virtual reality goggles, they could do that. They could do a 3D effect. So looking at the camera again, does it have stereo lenses? Is it two-lensed?
Let's look.
And Rhonda's trying
Would you cut it out?
trying to navigate her internet connection.
Yes, it does look like
here.
It looks like it has more than that.
Okay.
Looking at the camera itself.
Yeah, so it could very well be 3D. So I spoke too soon probably on that. Mm-hmm. We'll have to take a look at this. But, you know, I don't know. It right now, it just seems like it's such a, you know, if there's any, does it have a cost to convert the images to?
Yeah, I think it was like $49 a month.
Oh, so there's a membership for you again. Yeah, all right. So pretty much Rhonda's not doing this because she doesn't like
that
membership fee.
But, you know, if you went into this type of business where you wanted to go into like some of the upper end hotels and say, okay, you know, I've got a great advertisement here and show you what I could do and I can show off your hotel. People can walk through the rooms. They can walk through the lobby. I mean,
people that have virtual reality goggles or
just going online.
Yeah, online, but it's just kind of a panorama looking thing on. Well, I don't know. It is interesting. We'll have to, this bears watching, and certainly for commercial
purposes,
for the right use, you know, I think it's pretty interesting. I don't know.
The average person using it? Probably not.
Not
but,
yet.
But, you know.
But, you know, that's going to change. You know, it's going to take a while to.
Yeah, it says it uses an array of 2D and 3D sensors.
Okay, fine.
Right there.
All right. Well, what else you got?
Okay, what else do I have?
Because I'm pretty much out of stuff here.
Really?
Yeah, I've.
Okay.
I've run out of everything on my computer.
All right.
It's pretty much like. No,
really?
I don't have anything else left.
All right. Well, this is. Here. I know Rhonda's still clicking away. Don't listen to me. This is the 3D Fly, which is kind of like a 3D GoPro, kind of.
Okay, now I'm sick. Motion sickness watching Rhonda's camera there.
So that it shows you. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. So there it is. There's the fly.
Ah. It looks like a tennis ball, a little black ball that you have screwed onto the handlebars of a bicycle for this particular. And this is an action camera. The guy's riding over bumpy. This is kind of reminds me of like the Ricoh Theta S.
Kind again. Of. But it looks
it's
like
a PhotoSphere, right?
So, uh-huh.
And you're looking at it on your smartphone, and you can use your finger and you can pull it around. And yeah, it's just a PhotoSphere like we're now seeing on Facebook and YouTube. Do PhotoSphere. So here's a new PhotoSphere.
It's a new PhotoSphere.
We have PhotoSpheres. There's a couple of LGs making one. Samsung's making one. It's like Nikon's announced one. We're on this PhotoSphere bandwagon. We're gonna be PhotoSphered to death.
PhotoSphered to death.
It's like, you know, when you go to a movie anymore, you know, it's like the CG graphics, you know, the computer graphics are explosions and, you know, everything's flying at your head. And it's like, just give me a movie that has a plot. And I don't really care about the special effects anymore. I'm getting really jaded from
it. Did you watch The Revenant?
No, because, you know, I like bears. and I don't want to see the CG bear get hurt.
Yeah.
You know, I probably have to see it because I didn't see the Titanic
need to see it.
For a long time either because I knew how it was going to end. You know, mm-hmm. I'm like, you haven't seen the Titanic yet? Like, oh, the boat sinks. I don't need to see it.
The cinematography boat sinks. That's in The Revenant is breathtaking.
Yeah, you said that to me, but then you also said that they didn't use any lighting or reflectors. They just used available light.
They used mostly available and light to do it. That is the truth. That's
and I don't know about you, but my camera's available light needs some help.
Well,
you know, I mean, the available light is not always good.
Really, really good. You should go and see it. You'll like it.
Do you think it was because they were able to process the, they were shooting in RAW, uh-huh. you know, in the sLog, RAW video format, and then they can use the software to adjust the contrast ratios and to brighten certain areas.
Possible.
And, you know, you could manipulate it a lot using Adobe Premiere or Premiere Pro, one of the video editing programs. We'll have to see it.
You'll have to see it. Yeah. It's breathtaking, really, 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 really.
I did see the movie that I saw was, last one I saw was...
Sounds like... Mm. It's been a long time since you've seen a movie.
No, it wasn't that long ago. I just can't. Oh, Deadpool.
Deadpool. Oh, Deadpool was good. Mm-hmm. Did you like Deadpool?
I did like Deadpool, but it is rated R, and I think for reasons.
It's not a children's movie.
No.
No.
It is not a children's movie.
No. Yeah.
Some adults probably shouldn't see it either.
Probably.
But I don't know how you determine that.
If you have a very dark sense of humor, you should see it. If you do not go.
All right, so we have slipped off.
We fell off
the track again here.
But it still has to do with photography.
Well, it does have
just
to do with
cinematography.
But you know, there's a lot of movie review websites and blogs and whatnot, so we probably shouldn't slide
totally
into that because then we'll be just another Rotten Tomatoes.com.
There you go.
Yeah. All right, so you know what time it is.
Is it already? I'm not going to still be able to talk about the Trigger Trap mobile.
You have to save it for lunch. Save it for lunch. See where my head's at. Save it for lunch. We'll eat it later. We'll talk about it next week.
Okay.
You know, we got a bunch of stuff to talk about.
Okay.
I'll show you how to store those on your bookmarks.
So okay,
you
yeah.
You won't forget. Like I do. I got my bookmarks. I've got it all over the place. I keep talking about the same thing every week.
Over and over again.
I don't know anything about it. All right, everybody, have a great time this week. Take some pictures buy some new gear, spend a little money, come to coolphototools.com and click on one of our affiliate links and spend a lot of money so that, you know, the small percentage that we get in return will be larger and we will be able to buy some new gear and
talk about it. To tell you how it works. Yeah. So there you go.
Yeah. All right. Have a great week, everybody. Talk to you later.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
You've been listening to the Cool Photo Tools podcast. Sign up for our mailing list at coolphototools.com. Got a question? Send an email or MP3 audio file to info@coolphototools.com. Thanks for listening.